All right, everybody, welcome. Welcome to our kickoff reception, our kickoff news conference. A wonderful day for the National Black Theater Festival 2017 is back. Let's just give all the supporters and all the workers and yourself a great hand. Let's get the energy started in here. If you know anything about the National Black Theater Festival, you know we are full of energy, and this is a theater company, and it's full of drama in a good way. But we would like to welcome you to our kickoff news conference today. There's lots of elements going on today, but one of the major purposes today is to announce our celebrity co-chairs. We deem them our celebrity ambassadors during the week of the festival. And let me tell you, you will not be disappointed, as you are never, but today especially, we are so pleased to announce our celebrity co-chairs. But without further ado, 2017 National Black Theater Festival is July 31st through August 5th here in Winston-Salem. And make sure you tell everybody that you know, your mailman, your dog walker, it doesn't matter who. When you get your nails done, Cleo, tell her, whoever it is, to make sure that they're here for the festival this year. I would like to welcome to the stage our wonderful, fearless leader, who's president of the NCBRC. She's also executive producer of the MBTF, a woman who has taken on the charge to continue her husband's dream. We're here today because of Larry Leon Hamlin. We're here today because of his dream and everything that he's done to make this possible and to continue that dream is his lovely wife. And our fearless leader, please welcome Sylvia Sprinkle Hamlin.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the 2007 National Black Theater Festival. I'm so happy to see everybody here, especially the people in their purple and black. All roads lead to Winston-Salem, North Carolina, as we prepare for another international celebration of reunion and spirit. The eyes of the world will be on the 2017 National Black Theater Festival from July 31st through August 5th, 2017. Remember those dates. The NBTF Selection Committee has viewed over 120 submissions from theater companies from 20 states and over 50 cities from across the United States, Canada, South Africa, and the UK. Approximately 35 plays will be selected to perform on the main stage of the 2017 National Black Theater Festival. The 2017 National Black Theater Festival will open on Monday, July 31st with a much anticipated star-studded opening night gala, and gala tickets go on sale today. I hope all of you will be at the gala. It's wonderful, a wonderful experience. And guess what? We will be in the newly renovated Benton Convention Center. It's called The Benton. We are very excited about that. August 1st, you can select from a wide range of theatrical performances, including dramas, comedies, musicals, theaters for younger audience, multimedia presentations, college and university productions, and solo performances. We will have it all. Other components of the festival that will be in full force again this year will be the Authors Pavilion. You know I'm a librarian, so we gotta have some authors there. International Colloquium, the International Vendors Market, the Reader's Theater, and much, much more. The complete performance schedule and the list of celebrities and honorees will be announced at the next news conference that I hope you will be at, which will be June 5th, 2017. So there are two dates, well, actually three dates that you really need to keep in mind. The first date is July what? Through August. The second press conference will be June. Okay. Oh, that's just two dates. So we invite all of you to join us. We are saving a seat for you on Black Theater Holy Ground. As we say at the National Black Theater Festival, Black Theater is for everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, Sylvia. We could not do what we do without, obviously, funds and what you do in the community, our sponsors, and everyone that supports the National Black Theater Festival. I would like to bring to the podium a couple of people that are instrumental in making sure that this festival survives financially, and they have a way of getting in your pockets. So please welcome Mayor Alan Joynes and Nigel Austin.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Like last year, I don't know if it was Nigel or somebody called us Batman and Robin, so we'll continue that effort there. But it's always my pleasure to be here as mayor to help with the kickoff of the National Black Theater Festival 2017. We're about 5 months away from turning the city purple again. I see a lot of purple out there today. I got mine on. So we're happy to be a part of that. You know, the fundraising, as I said, is a key part of that, and we've I've been co-chair now ever since I've been mayor, and so we've worked hard to create regular funding sources. I think we also have to certainly recognize Councilmember Burke, who took a big role in making sure that the city of Winston-Salem stepped up, and we're putting in, I think, about $125,000 to help make this event happen. That's the most we put in any event around the city, so we're truly committed to that. I want to thank the National Black Theater Festival staff and their board. Thank you for the hard work that you do, as well as the volunteers, because it takes a lot of folks to make this event happen over that about 10-day period. A lot of things, a lot of moving parts, and so Winston-Salem's fortunate we've got people who step up. But I want to say thank you to our sponsors, and Nigel's going to recognize those in more detail. But again, we're so appreciative of the support of this community to make this wonderful event happen, because it's such an important part of the overall wonderful mosaic of the city of Winston-Salem. Thank you very much.
Well, good afternoon. We have a great tag team partnership. We have not decided yet who is Batman and who's Robin. So we're still working on that part. So I want to acknowledge our sponsors to date. If you're here, if you would please stand. If you work for one of these companies, if you would also stand at the same time. Wells Fargo, Twin City Quarter, City of Winston-Salem, Hanes Brands, Reynolds American, Visit Winston-Salem, Blue Cross Blue Shield of North Carolina, Winston-Salem State University, Wake Forest University. You ought to get into this routine of applauding now. That's good. Forsyth County, Arts Council of Winston-Salem Forsyth County, North Carolina Arts Council, Marvtastic Society, University of North Carolina School of the Arts, and Nissan America. So we want to thank all of these sponsors. If you know of others that we should be contacting, please see Alan or myself, or the mayor or myself, so we can make contact with them. The fundraising committee is underway right now. We look forward to an outstanding festival. Thank you very much for being here, and give the sponsors another round of applause.
The mayor already kind of gave a wonderful introduction to our next speaker. We'd like to welcome to the mic Dr. Vivian Burke, who was with Larry from the beginning and is such a friend and a partner for the festival. Please welcome Dr. Vivian Burke, our mayor pro tem.
Good afternoon. This is such a joyful time, and everybody should be just smiling. I'm going to ask everyone, when you smile, smile toward Mrs. Johnson, the mother of Larry, and the wife, Mrs. Hamlin. Let's smile toward them. Thank you. We are so grateful, this city, and we praise all of you who are important to this activity as we are to this activity. I want you to know this morning, I was thinking about Larry, and I thought about the time that we put Larry's name right there at the Stevens Center. And that day when we went down, Larry said he'd been waiting there for a long time. You remember, don't you, Mayor? And it wasn't cold that day, was it? It wasn't quite cold that day. It was a nice warm day. And he was so happy. And also, I thought about this city, how blessed we are to have this festival that's known around the world, as Sylvia said earlier. Once when I was doing something for Larry over at the Marriott, the man who was the manager said to me that I make a mistake when I call this the International Festival. I say no, because we have people coming here from all around the world, and we are grateful. I want you to know that we will show our purple, Sylvia. Wanda Merchel, who was the councilwoman from the Northwest Ward and also the finance chair, she made sure that the business people put their purple out. And it's going to be for the mayor and the council people, for us to say to the business people, we want to see purple on every block in the downtown area, starting as far as back as 4th Street, on up. And when we walk and we look at this city, we'll know that the Black Festival is here for everyone. And we'll tell the business people in this community that we want them to show it is purple. I know you had the purple rice last time with the menu, but we want them to know that purple is such a beautiful color, and that we want the people to know that we appreciate the people who work so hard to make this day a wonderful day when we start the festival. I'm gonna just say this and I'm gonna sit down. A lady called me nearly 2 weeks ago, and she said, I'm planning, we're coming back to Winston-Salem. I said, are they gonna catch the bus or take the plane? Well, the people from St. Louis will be taking the plane this year. And she says more will be coming. So I want to say to all of you, I cannot say enough about Ms. Smalls. You'll be bringing them in? All right then, there's Ms. Smalls back there. She'll be bringing people from St. Louis. I want to say to all of you in behalf, and as the mayor has expressed himself, in behalf of our council people, we are with this festival. As you saw the assistant city manager stand up again. And we also have now work for the county, but we have now doing our budget director stand up. You know the role she plays with the Black Festival. And I know she'll be looking at that budget, making sure we're gonna find the money that we need and do the things that we need to do. You whisper that to the city manager when you get back there. Okay, so again, thank you so very much. And the 250-some thousand people in this city, we are grateful and we cannot wait for the great occasion. And may God bless all of you. Thank you.
It takes partnership with everyone in the community to make this wonderful festival happen, and I would like to welcome to the stage Jim Sparrow, who's president and CEO of the Arts Council of Winston-Salem for Scythe County. Give Jim a hand, please.
Good afternoon. It's kind of daunting after you have to follow Dr. Burke, but I will say that now I've been here, this is going on my fourth year, and having actually gone through one of these festivals, one of the things I've grown to appreciate the most about being in our great city that supports the arts is our festivals. I think it's a unique thing that we do here in Winston, and at the top of those festivals is the National Black Theater Festival. After having gone through a full festival and seeing what the city does and becomes during that festival, I think it's something that we don't want to miss. So with that, I'm going to get off the stage, but I completely understand now that when you see purple and black, the festival's back. So we'll see you soon.
The Winston-Salem Convention and Visitors Bureau is always a partner, and they make the city just ready and wonderful and perfect for the festival every year. So please welcome Richard Geiger, who's Winston-Salem Convention with the Winston-Salem Convention and Visitors Bureau.
Thank you. Good afternoon. And on behalf of the Visit Winston-Salem and the TDA and the entire hospitality community, I'm honored to be here on behalf of them and to say thank you, and we're a very proud sponsor of the National Black Theater Festival. The festival and its performances, its opening evening gala, the independent films, the national celebrities that are here have truly become a part of the entire fabric and the fiber of what Winston-Salem is. The six-day event that brings tens of thousands of people here, spending millions of dollars, has really become an opportunity for us to enhance the brand of Winston-Salem. It is helping make us truly the city of arts, the city of innovation, city of theater, and of course, a city with strong and great African-American heritage. All these things help create a stronger brand and help our city become a better visitor attraction and visitor destination, bringing more people back, not only for the festival, but for many of the other arts and other types of cultural institutions we have in this town. The team at Visit Winston-Salem is ready. We will be getting downtown full of purple, Mrs. Burke, as part of the role we will play, amongst others. But we do enjoy working with the team at the National Black Theater Festival, and are looking forward to the July 31st through August 5th, 2017 event. And as Sylvia indicated, they'll be at the brand new convention, renovated Benton Convention Center. Center will be open in March, actually in May. So it gives Grant a couple of months to work any kinks out long before you get here, Sylvia. So we'll be good to go when you're here at the end of July. But again, on behalf of the hospitality industry, Visit Winston-Salem, we're delighted to be a sponsor and a partner with the National Black Theater Festival. Thank you very much.
Work the kinks out. You got a little while to do that. So anyway, we are excited. There's so many ways to actually support the festival, and you can actually do it right here today, right? They told me to go for the close. You can do it today by being a part of our wonderful organization. So I would like to welcome to the stage the president of our Gill Theater Gill, and I'd like to personally thank her for being on a live shot this morning at 6:30 a.m. You look marvelous. Also, that's Renita Brewington and John Singleton, who is an NCBRC board member. Please welcome Renita and John. John Singleton. Singleton.
Good afternoon. Put on your purple and black because the festival is back. Now, I want to take a few minutes to tell how you may not be an actor or an actress or a director or a playwright, but how you can play an important role in ensuring the success of the 2017 National Black Theater Festival. Now, there's a better way that you can demonstrate your understanding of what the National Black Theater Festival means to our city, our region, and our state by joining the Marvtastic Society. Any Marvtastic Society members present today? Where are you? All right. For those of you who are already Marvtastic Society members, I hope you've renewed your memberships today. But Marvtastic Society members make a donation of $1,000 to cover their participation for 2 years. In return, they receive an array of exciting benefits, such as a pair of tickets to all of the North Carolina Black Repertory Company's productions during that 2-year period. They also receive early admissions during the theater festival. And you also are invited to our biannual Purple and Black Ball. Now, another option for those who want to participate in the festival is to join the North Carolina Black Repertory Theater Guild. Any Theater Guild members present? Where are you? Now, Guild members, they range from $500 all the way down to $25. They also receive an array of benefits. John?
Thank you, Renita. You know, I always come after Renita. She's such a performer. I just talk, you know. I'm like, why am I here? I just want her to do the whole thing next time. But anyway, that aside, funds generated by the Society and the Guild are used to cover the constantly rising costs of bringing the best of Black theater from across the country and around the world. More than any single event, the National Black Theater Festival focuses attention on our little corner of the world. With that attention come thousands of visitors who fill our hotel rooms, restaurants, and retail stores. So if you believe in the vision of the late Larry Leon Hamlin and what his vision continues to mean for our community, please join the inner circle of friends who are Marftastic Society members or Guild members. Did everyone pick up one of these brochures from the back information table? If you haven't, please do, because it has lots of good background information about the festival, what you can anticipate, and perhaps more importantly, it has a sign-up form on the back, which you could actually take advantage of now, if you'd like. But certainly don't delay. The 2017 National Black Theater Festival will be here before we know it. And while you might not have the unique talents to be a performer, you can play a very important part in making the 2017 festival one of the best ever. Thank you very much.
Guys, there's actually sign-up cards for the Guild and Marftastic. Raise your hand, the Gwens back here. They can sign you up today, so we appreciate that. And Renita hasn't had coffee. That's scary. We appreciate you. We appreciate all that, Renita. You know, the youth were so important to Larry. He always wanted to make sure that there was a component in the festival that embraced our young people. And we took a hard look at that and created what we call Teen-tastic, which gives teens during the week of the festival their own kind of mini festival. And we have a very wonderful, diligent, beautiful person that's in charge of Teen-tastic, and she's here to give you an update on that. Please welcome Demetria Nickens.
Thank you, everybody. Teen-tastic will once again this year work closely with the City of Winston-Salem Parks and Recreation and Parks Department to immerse teens into the arts on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night of the festival. The new director, William Royston, and I will put on a Teen-tastic experience bigger and better than last year's festival. Be on the lookout for more information to come surrounding the specifics of each event. The Winston-Salem Fairgrounds will be a sea of teenagers, hopefully all in their purple and black. Thank you.
And part of the youth, Cleo, stand up. Cleo Solomon is part, it works and heads our Celebrity Youth Project. So Cleo, thank you very much for everything that you do. We also like to thank, and we were remiss to announce that Novant is also a sponsor of the festival. So please give Novant a hand for helping us out. Thank you very much. And you also have an opportunity to participate in the festival by volunteering. And this next person is a jewel for the festival. Llewellyn Corey, please come up and talk about some of the volunteer opportunities for the festival. Please welcome Llewellyn Corey. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brian. And thank you to all of you for being here this afternoon. It is a joy for me to be here, and I know it's a joy for my co-coordinator, volunteer co-coordinator, Patrice Tony, also. We don't always say this, but I know we believe that it is a great honor to be the volunteer co-coordinators, and that we feel the responsibility, but we also appreciate the trust we've been given to work with the volunteers. As we do always say, we could not do this festival without the volunteers. It would be impossible. We have some of the most amazing volunteers that you could ever want. They give and they give and they give. They work so hard, and they are what makes this festival, as I said, makes this festival possible. I say to them every festival, they are the face of the festival. I've had people stop me on the street, really right out here, outside of the convention center, to tell me how wonderful the volunteers have been and how much they were enjoying the festival, especially how they were being treated by the volunteers. So again, we say thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, we welcome back these volunteers who have worked so hard in the past in the festivals, but we also want to encourage and invite and welcome new volunteers. We have many, many things for volunteers to do. I'm not going to try in my time allotted to go through all of them, but if you'll go to our website, nbtf.org, National Black Theater Festival, nbtf.org, you can click on the link for volunteers and get some additional information. So over the next few weeks, you will be hearing more from us about how to become a volunteer. I would like to recognize the volunteers who are here. If you could please stand so everyone could see you in your purple and black. Come on, I see you out there. Stand up. Miss Cleo, you should stand too. Thank you. So once again, thank you for being here. Thank you for all the support, really, from the city and the county and the Visitors Bureau. We couldn't do this without them either. All the things that you've heard so far, but especially to our volunteers. So let's go forward and make this the best, most marvelous festival ever. Thank you.
All right, next, we are excited. It is here. We're going to shortly announce our celebrity co-chairs. I just put them on standby to let them know that they're up soon. But to introduce them and to kind of give you a little teaser, see if you can guess them before she gets to the give, is a wonderful member of what we call our MBTF family, our NCBRC family. We love her, and we thank her for doing this almost every festival. She has a way of with words. So please welcome to introduce our celebrity co-chairs. Please welcome Dr. Elwanda Ingram. And you see how I lowered the mic? Okay.
Good afternoon, everyone. What do our 2017 National Black Theater Festival celebrity co-chairs have in common? They are both native New Yorkers. Prior to coming to Hollywood, they had a solid list of accomplishments on and off Broadway. I will share only a partial listing of their outstanding achievements. She appeared in the Broadway production of For Colored Girls. He received a Tony nomination for his role in the original Broadway production of Dreamgirls. She was nominated for Outstanding Special Guest Performer in a Drama Series at the 43rd Daytime Emmy Awards. He received the 2016 Daytime Emmy Award for Outstanding Guest Performer in a Drama Series on the same show, but I'm not gonna tell you their names yet. TV audiences loved him as the wealthy father of two half-sisters in the now syndicated television comedy series, Half and Half, as well as appearances on The Young and the Restless, Boston Legal, Grey's Anatomy, NCIS, Cold Cases, and Strong Medicine. Are you thinking about who it might be? Yeah. He is excited about his new talk show, Go Beyond the Lens, with, as I said, I'm still not gonna tell you his name. He's also thrilled about his made-for-TV series, Horse Talk, in which he demonstrates his rare talents as a horse whisperer. She has made guest appearances on such sitcoms as The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Grey's Anatomy, Sparks, Moesha, The Bernie Mac Show, The Shield, Girlfriends, and Everybody Hates Chris. Some of her film credits include Tyler Perry's A Madea Christmas, Our Family Wedding, Gridiron Gang, Broken Bridges, Street Smart, Minority Report, Along Came a Spider, Kiss the Girls, Set It Off, Presumed Innocent, St. Elmo's Fire, Friday and Friday After Next. He has appeared in more than 17 stage productions, 30 theatrical films, 60 made-for-television movies, starred in many specials and two primetime series, plus dozens of other singing and dancing appearances. It is easy to understand why this Renaissance man is often referred to as one of the busiest actors in Hollywood. This season, he has two new series that will be airing, Dear White People for Netflix, and I'm Dying Up Here on Showtime. He just completed principal photography alongside Forest Whitaker and Johnny Depp in the feature film Labyrinth. Both of our co-chairs' acting talents are coupled with their behind-the-scenes skills. She was a producer for the PBS series Soul. He was a co-producer and director of Oscar's Black Odyssey, co-producer of Dorothy Dandridge and American Beauty, and co-producer of TV in Black, The First 50 Years. He is associate producer of the horror classic film Voodoo Dolls. They both appeared in the film How High. She has provided an infinite amount to society and her community through her service, her diverse capabilities, and her talent. During her first years in Hollywood, she became spokesperson and fundraiser for the Institute of Black Parenting. She was awarded the title Ambassador of Tourism in Antigua. Her service to autism was recognized and saluted by the Barbados Association of California. She received the Lifetime Achievement Award from the Department of Black Studies at the University of Nebraska, Omaha, the Commitment of Excellence and Humanity Award from Sigma Gamma Rho, the Generations of Light Award from the American Bible Society, and the Salute to Women in Leadership 2015 Lifetime Achievement Award presented by the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. Keep waiting, keep waiting. You will know very soon. He received an Emmy nomination for his performance in the HBO movie Miss Evers Boys, an NAACP Image Award nomination for the TV movie introducing Dorothy Dandridge. He originated the role of Jelly Roll Morton in the world premiere of Jelly's Last Jam and starred as Sammy Davis Jr. in the Broadway-bound musical Sammy, for which he won Best Actor. Some of his feature film appearances include The Celestine Prophecy, Material Girls, After the Sunset, The Manchurian Candidate, The Notebook, John Q, That Thing You Do, and Philadelphia. He directed and co-stars with Cat Williams in the Lionsgate Home Entertainment feature film, American Bad Boy, and produced and directed the multi-award-winning short film, Clarissa's Gift. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, it gives me great pleasure to present these multi-talented artists who portray husband and wife, Julius and Vivian Avant, on the CBS daytime series, The Bold and the Beautiful. Any of you watch that? He created the role of Cece, Jennifer Holliday's brother, in the original hit Broadway production of Dreamgirls. And she created the tough rent-a-cop Dee Baxter on the popular The Wayans Brothers, and the beloved bachelorette Thelma Fry, Sherman Hemsley's daughter on NBC's Amen. Both shows are currently in syndication. Please welcome our 2017 National Black Theater Festival co-chairs, Oba Babatunde and Anna Maria Horsford.
Is that not the longest introduction in history? You know everything except when we're gonna die, okay? Everything. Hi, I'm happy to be here in all this purple and black. Yes, and this is my wonderful husband. My TV husband. Okay, all right.
Greetings, how's everyone? We all marvtastic to see me. Is this not a sensational and great situation to be at, to be celebrating? You know, I'm overjoyed and honored to stand here for many, many, many reasons. You know, there are many people and faces that I recognize over the years. Mabel Robinson is a dear heart friend of mine. We have worked together many years and have known each other. When you know someone for an extent of, like, I think it's been like almost 40 years of friendship. And, you know, that's rare. And I'm not talking about Facebook friendship.
Right.
I'm talking about actual friendship. And many of the other faces that I see, I'm thrilled to be here. It's a marvtastic situation. I was part of the original festival participants when it first started. And so to be back here as a co-chair with the sensational Anna Marie Horsford. You know, we play husband and wife on Bold and the Beautiful, as you're well aware of. But, you know, Anna and I have also been friends for many years. We've worked on projects together, but this particular project with Bold and the Beautiful is the first time we got an actual opportunity to work in the same scenes together.
Yeah.
We've done productions together, but we weren't in the same scenes.
Yeah.
And it's really a special, special thing for those of you that are fans of Bold and the Beautiful. And thank you for your support there, because those characters, as you see them developed, weren't necessarily created to be the characters that you actually saw. We had to take that into our hands because we wanted to make sure that what we were doing represented us, not as isms, not as, you know, just a mom, and the mom gets it, the dad doesn't, blah, 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 but there's a difference between villainizing a character and dehumanizing a character. And so we took those things seriously because we know that we represent you, everyone that's in here, and the people around the world that live in this hue. And we wanted to represent it in a way, and we hope that we've been able to do that, in a way that afforded you to feel that you could relate to the story because it was born out of our community. So, we're honored to be here. I don't want to stand up here. We're going to be talking a lot as the day goes along. And but we're just honored. We stood back there and I said, Anna, do you remember that you did that? And she says, oh, but did you remember you did that? So it was nice. It was like a walk down memory lane, you know,
yeah. To
be able to hear all of the things that we have been fortunate enough to be a part of.
Yes.
Again, I thank you. Anna, you want to tell them how much you appreciate them?
Okay. I just want to say how much I appreciate you coming to support
this thing that people have been saying is a dying art. And you prove everyone wrong, because theater is alive and well, if no place else on earth, but in Winston-Salem, North Carolina. And this is what gives the energy and the motivation for every little child who has a dream to say, I want to do that. Sometimes you can't necessarily spend the $15 or $20 to go to the movies, but you can see that little church production. I remember my mother started, because I was a bad child, and she started us off in day school, and we had to recite, you know, in the church, and they would give you a little poem, and you didn't know what you didn't have a clue what it meant. But if you memorize it, especially James Weldon Johnson, the creation, you got a standing ovation. And you said, wow, this feels good. So I thank everybody here for supporting the babies, supporting the teens, supporting, because when children see that somebody is watching and documenting them, and they see it on a stage, it wakes something up in you, and it allows you to bring forth the gift that God has planted in you. And I thank you all for being here today. Thank you so much.
Now, you know, we're about theater. We want to give you a little taste of what's to come. But first, we would like to bring to the stage our artistic director, our, I don't know if we can keep saying new Jackie, but our new artistic director for the NCBRC. Please welcome Jackie Alexander.
Good afternoon. I'm so excited. My first festival was in 2005. I actually got to meet Mr. Hamlin, and I actually directed a show that performed in this very building. So to be back is amazing, and to be here as artistic director, I gotta keep pinching myself. I've been doing that for like 6 months. But my first festival, the question I kept asking myself is, how did Mr. Hamlin pull this off? And I got my answer going home. We left the hotel Sunday morning. Someone picked us up at like 6 a.m. to get to the airport. We started talking to him on the drive home. He said, I take 1 week of vacation every year to work the festival. It's the only week I get off during the whole year. And he takes that week to drive us around, pick us up, and bring us to the festival. Since I've been in Winston-Salem, that's the spirit I found from everybody. This event is one of the most beautiful experiences I've ever had. And I'm so excited to be here. But I'm here to talk to you about the North Carolina Black Repertory Theater. Without that, there would be no National Black Theater Festival, okay? So we want all of you to come and become a part of our family. We're doing a lot of exciting things this year so far. We've partnered with Susan G. Komen on The Sting of White Roses. We partnered with the North Carolina chapter of the ALS Association on The Right Reverend Dupree in Exile, which is performing now. This weekend is the final weekend. And our third show of the season, Maid's Door, we're partnering with the Wake Forest Stick Center for Alzheimer's Research and Arbor Acres. So we're doing a lot of important work. I think they're gonna hand out our upcoming season, which is a mix of classics, world premieres, and it's amazing. Come and be a part of our family. We need you, we need your support. The festival's here every 2 years. The North Carolina Black Rep is here year round. Okay, year round. We wanna see you there. To give you a little taste of what we're doing, we're gonna bring up three actors from The Right Reverend Dupree in Exile and do a short excerpt from the show. So I'm gonna ask Philip Lynch, April Davis, and Brandon Jones to come up and give you a little piece of The Right Reverend Dupree in Exile.
Definitely your first time visiting.
I think this is the perfect place to spend the holiday.
I wouldn't relax too much with your feet in that water. The gators around here probably looking for an early Christmas dinner.
Really?
No, he's just messing with you.
That is not nice.
I'm sorry.
This must have been a great place to come when you were children.
Yeah, I guess so. Though I don't think many would describe time spent with my father as peaceful or relaxing.
You exaggerate. He's not that bad.
Not that bad. The man who within 10 minutes of meeting you labeled you an unbeliever.
He also welcomed me into his home. We will not be planning a trip to my father's home anytime soon.
Well, it's just the arrogance that gets me.
What would you have him do? Lie to us? Betray his beliefs to make us feel more comfortable?
Alu, the man basically told you that you were unworthy of marrying his son.
A universal flaw of all mankind.
Excuse me?
The need to feel superior to others. Be it religion, race, economic status. There is always a reason close at hand.
So that excuse makes it okay?
Not okay, just understandable. And it does not make him a bad person.
She's got a point.
What are you talking about? And I never said he was a bad person.
Look, just about every woman I done dated in the past 3 years thought they was too good to marry me.
Are you kidding?
No, I'm serious. When I played in China, I dated this chick who gave me the run of her apartment. Plus, she let me use her car. But she ain't want to be seen out in public with me. When I played in Italy, I dated this girl who was about the same color as me. She used to cook for me every night, wash my clothes, and everything. But then she acted like she ain't know me when I ran into her one night out with her family. Hell, when I played in Brazil, I dated this chick who was damn near darker than you. No offense.
None taken.
Well, anyway, this girl's family had a lot of money. She ain't make me pay for nothing. Wined and dined me every night. She said I was the first black man that she had ever dated.
I thought you said
don't ask. I still don't know what she was talking about when it comes to that. Well, anyway, this girl's sister's getting married, right? So I offer to go to the wedding, and she says, no thanks. I don't think that'd be socially acceptable.
Brandon!
It's okay. I laughed about 15 minutes when she told me.
You are not insulted?
No, indeed. I didn't want to go to that wedding anyway. I just thought it was a good idea to offer since I wanted her to keep taking me out. Now look, I'll be honest. I don't think none of these chicks were bad people.
What?
They weren't. They had just been brainwashed to a certain way of thinking.
And so that excuse makes it okay?
Not okay, just understandable.
I cannot believe what I'm hearing from you two.
As long as you do not infringe on someone else's rights, everyone is entitled to their own opinion.
So you're saying it's okay the way those women treated Kenny?
That is for Kenny to decide.
I ain't have no problem with it, bro. Look, I had a good time and saved a whole hell of a lot of money.
I can't have this conversation any longer.
Right Reverend Dupree in Exile is playing now at the Arts Council Theater. Please get your tickets. And is Mabel still here? I just wanted to thank Mabel for her many years of service to the NCBRC, Mabel Robinson.
Yay!
And also, I certainly have to thank and recognize a woman that the festival wouldn't be here without her, because Larry wouldn't have been here. Annie Hamlin Johnson, known as Mama Marv-tastic. We love you so much. Please stand. Everyone give Mama Marv-tastic a hand. Thank you. And in closing, Llewellyn, help me. And in closing, I heard someone has a birthday today. And that would be our own celebrity co-chair, Anna Maria Horsford's birthday is today. Happy birthday. What a way to celebrate your birthday. Guys, don't forget, the festival is July 31st through August 5th. Throughout many venues here in Winston-Salem, please log on to mbtf.org or NCBRC, the North Carolina Black Rep.org, for all the information. Also, we'll be having another news conference on June 5th. to announce the shows that have been chosen and to go forward with the festival. Guys, it is back. We started early, so you can put it on your calendars, your radar, and make sure everyone knows about the 2017 National Black Theater Festival. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in August.